Southampton, England Stuart Taylor cherishes those few moments before the game starts. Almost two decades since his professional debut, the sense of occasion still strikes him as special, the vibrant green of the field, the sight of the stadium starting to fill, the sound gathering, the anticipation mounting. He soaks it all in as he warms up for 15 or 20 minutes with Southampton's other goalkeepers, Fraser Forster and Alex McCarthy. Taylor stands on the sideline, swinging crosses in for one or the other to catch, or positions himself directly in front of them, peppering them with shots, gently tuning up their reflexes. When they are ready, all three return to the dressing room. Forster, an England international, and McCarthy strip off their training gear and prepare for the game. But unless one has suffered a late injury, Taylor does the opposite. He puts on his club tracksuit. He heads upstairs and takes a seat in the stands. His work is over before the game starts. His job, from that point on, is simply to watch. That is what Taylor has done for much too much of the last 18 years. Before Southampton, he played for Arsenal, Aston Villa, and Manchester City, among others, and yet it feels like he has barely played at all, just 95 times in total, only 10 games since 2009 and not at all since 2015. He looks back on his career with no little fondness. The players he has called teammates, the clubs he has called home, but substantially more frustration at the lot he was assigned. Taylor has spent his entire career marooned in soccer's most unappreciated, unwelcome role, backup goalkeeper. That, he knows, has earned him a reputation. "There is definitely a perception of me," he said. He paints it, a little angrily, as that of a man who loves going round clubs, earning money for doing nothing. He is often told that he must be a multimillionaire after so long in the Premier League. It is not a description that he recognizes on any number of levels. He laughs at the idea that, at 37, he will soon retire into a life of idle bliss. "I will have to work," he said. "People assume I have made serious money. I really haven't." He dismisses the notion that his job is a sinecure, that he sits around doing nothing, turning up for training, having a jolly, messing about. What grates most, though, is the idea that this was all deliberate. This is not the career Taylor envisaged. He has done all he can to escape his unwanted pigeonhole. "He remains baffled," he said, frustrated that he has been unable to do so. "And he is not the only one. Every coach I have had, every goalkeeper I have worked with, has said I should have played 200 or 300 Premier League games," Taylor said. "I look back at it and think the same." As a teenager, Taylor was earmarked for greatness, poached by Arsenal after a brief spell at Wimbledon, hothoused with the rest of English soccer's brightest young things at the now-defunct School of Excellence at Lille. He represented England at under-16, under-18, under-20, and under-21 level, and seemed to have been earmarked as a possible long-term heir to Arsenal's long-time goalkeeper, David Seaman, alongside Richard Wright, another young English prospect. In 2002, Arsenal won the Premier League title, all three played at least 10 times, ensuring each a winner's medal. By 2003, Taylor was the undisputed deputy to Jens Lehmann, an experienced German international. He missed much of that season through injury, and in the summer, Arsene Wenger brought in Manuel Almunia, a Spaniard, as Lehmann's understudy. Wenger told a devastated Taylor he would understand if he chose to leave. 2 years later, he did, joining Aston Villa. Taylor said he had been promised he would have opportunities to play, if Thomas Sorensen, the club's first choice, was injured, or in poor form, he would be called upon. They never materialized, he said. I kept being told I would play this game or that game, and I never did. You get your hopes up, and it's hard to take. Football is a cruel game. People tell you what they think you want to hear. Even when Sorensen left, Villa signed Brad Friedel and Brad Guzan. Taylor was demoted to deputy to the deputy. He took a loan spell at Cardiff City, in the second-tier championship, hoping a Premier League team would notice me and give me a chance. I always had an eye on the bigger picture, Taylor said. In 2009, he signed for Manchester City, as cover for Shay. Given the bionic man, he'd have an arm falling off and he'd still play, expecting chances in the FA and League Cups. When, a year later, Joe Hart returned to the club from a loan spell, Taylor was number three again. From there, he went to Reading, and then to Leeds, in a fruitless search for games. Between 2012 and 2015, he played only 9 times. His patience ran out. You go round thinking things will happen, that surely you will get games, and it becomes very demoralizing, he said. I was fed up. He left Leeds, and left soccer. He started drawing up retirement plans, including a goalkeeping school. He had watched enough. Taylor cuts a popular, breezy figure at Southampton's training facility. He has a word for everyone, from players to the staff. He knows which coaches are in charge of which academy teams, and what time the receptionists go home. He has always been like this, at all of his clubs. At Manchester City, Given recalled how his supposed rival for a place used to greet him at halftime with a kind word, a confidence boost. He'd just say great save, or tell you how well you'd played, Given said. Just small things that helped. Taylor also became known as the club's entertainment manager, as Given puts it, a role he has continued at Southampton in some form. Though he is well aware that he is not employed just to have banter, he sees part of his responsibility as pastoral. I have been brought here to help with the dynamic, he said. To keep things happy and bubbly, to try and be a good influence. His job, though, is to be a goalkeeper. They wouldn't have me here if I couldn't play in goal, he said. He takes his work extremely seriously. Taylor said that his focus during training is on making more saves than his rivals, Forster and McCarthy. Afterward, he regularly stays out with the club's strikers, helping them with extra shooting practice. I enjoy that competitive side of them trying to beat me, he said. I don't want them to beat me. Part of that is down to experience. He learned, at Arsenal, that sometimes teams do need 3 goalkeepers, that is why he still has a Premier League winner's medal in his father-in-law's safe. He found out at Villa, too, that switching off is not an option. We had a game against Manchester City, he remembered. Sorensen was injured in the warm-up. I'd half switched off by then, and I had a stinker. He points out, too, that Paulo Gazzaniga, Tottenham's third-choice goalkeeper, was drafted in for a game earlier this season. If you don't prepare properly, you'll only make yourself look stupid, he said. But Taylor's commitment to diligent preparation also is because he is so happy to be here, in the Premier League, doing what he loves. After he left Leeds, He had chances to sign for clubs lower down England's pyramid, in League One and League Two. He turned them down. People will say I am wrong, but I wanted to play at the highest level I thought I could play at, he said. I felt I was good enough to be in the Premier League. Dropping down, even if it meant more games, would have been an admission that he was not. He wonders, now, if that was the right approach, if he could do it all again, he said, maybe he would take a step back to take two forward. His 8-year-old son is an aspiring goalkeeper, and Taylor acknowledged that he would advise a totally different path to me. But he is not the sort, it is clear, to wallow in self-pity. He eulogizes all the players he has called teammates, from Dennis Bergkamp and Thierry Henry to Sergio Aguero, and he is effusive about his year and a half at Southampton, the club that enticed him back. His year out of the game was a strain. He would watch games on television and feel he could still do that. Southampton approached him through Hart, his former teammate at City. This time, he went in with his eyes open. He was signed as cover, as support. Nobody promised me anything, he said. I know my role. His life on England's south coast is not a glamorous one, and it is not an easy one, either. Taylor lives alone in an apartment in nearby Winchester. His wife and three children are back in Romford, a suburb east of London, a few hours northeast. He only signs 1-year contracts now, and it is not worth tearing his sons and daughter away from home. He often finds himself alone in the gym when everyone else has gone home. But the life is one he enjoys, one he has unwillingly trained for all these years. He is an excellent, expert backup goalkeeper. There is already talk that Southampton might offer him another year's contract. Here, at least, he is appreciated. It is dark by the time Taylor has finished speaking. The parking lot is almost empty. Even Alfie, the black cat who has taken up residence at the training ground, has gone. Taylor says goodbye, and then turns to his left, back through the door behind reception, back inside. This is his work. He is not yet ready to leave.